Let's just sew whatever. All right, so this is from Woodland Quilt Works. I don't know what it is, because I can't remember if I ordered something or not. Oh yeah. So these are for my chain stitch embroidery machine. They're like thread loopers. I don't love the one I have, so I thought this might be a little bit easier. Not 100% sure. I think it will actually, but it's got like this little piece here. So you stick this down, you loop that through, and then you just slide it up. So I think these will work very nicely. The ones I have aren't terrible, but they're just like really big and bulky, so I'm not a huge fan of that. So I'm excited to try these. All right, this next one is from Swoon. If you've not heard of Swoon, they're my absolute favorite for printing custom fabrics, especially since it's smaller quantities. And my favorite base to use is the linen cotton canvas. So what did I order? Oh, I ordered fabric. This was a custom order. She sent me the image that she wanted repeated on the fabric. So that is for a custom ordered backpack. And what I do is I like fill the yard with zipper pouches and things like that too. Just so it's like a little less wasted fabric. So I'm excited to have that so I can work on that custom order. This next one is from Michael Miller Fabrics. I have a really fun video coming up that I am excited to do, and it is kind of in, it's not like sponsored by, but it is on behalf of Ulfa Rotary and Cutting Supplies. So they told me to pick out these like comic themed fabrics from Michael Miller to use, and I'm excited. My fabric haul, they're so fun. So these are from, like I said, Michael Miller Fabrics. I'm excited to play with those. Next. Oh, this is from Holly Hauser of Caffeinated Stitches. She sells press plates for, different rivet presses and stuff like that, so that you can do multiple things with it. They're really cool. But I wanted to use it for grommets. So she sells these press plate razors, basically, so that you can shorten the distance between them. So I'm really excited about this. I think this is like $30 and it's super strong. So I'm excited to play with that with rivets. So thank you so much, Holly, for answering my ignorant questions. As far as that was concerned, and shipping it so quickly. This next one, let's see what's in here. This is from Cindy. I bought some vinyl from Cindy, and we had a little bit of, I had some misunderstanding, I should say. So she was really sweet and let me send it back and keep what worked for me. And she sent a little gift for me and Ben. I wonder where Ben is at the moment. Oh, hey, there he is. Ben. What? Oh my gosh, it's so cute! Ah! Oh, I love it so much. So it's just this little succulent that she potted in here. Or maybe she bought it like this, I don't know, but it's so cute. Ben, what do you think? You like it? Come here. Help me open my mail. What do you think? He's like, no one should look at it except me. What do you like it? He likes it. Thank you, Cindy. Oh, I'm gonna put it in my bathroom. It's so cute. who likes it. All right, this next one is from My Punk Broidery. They have every Tuesday a Thankful Tuesday sale, and I think I finally like went to bed early that night or something, and I was like, I gotta get something while everything's on sale. So that's what's in this box. I'm gonna open it gently. These are always so well wrapped. Those ladies know what they're doing. Slip first. Okay, got it all out. Wow, this is their gem fabric. Wow, so this is gonna be very domestic machine friendly. You can feel the glitter, but it's not coarse or rough. It's like a flexible but durable, like cardstock almost. It's so pretty. the glitter looks like it's coming off on my hands a little bit, but it's not like dusting everywhere, if that makes sense, and it's still pretty soft to touch. It's not like touching sandpaper or anything, so that's cool if you're looking to add some sparkle to something but you don't want like thick or sticky glitter vinyl or something. This could be a really good alternative, and it's their glitter gem fabric. Nice little sample of that. Oh, and post-it notes. I love these so much. I always keep them around for adding notes to different bags and stuff like that. All right, so this is their Violet Sparkle Canvas. Ooh. What's nice about the Sparkle Canvas is it's not too thick, so if you have a domestic machine and you want to try glittery fun things, this is definitely a way to go. And then it's not too sticky, but it is smooth. Kind of smells like nail polish. I'm not mad at it though, like a good nail polish. And this is so pretty. This is the violet color. Yeah. And I like to use these on Devon's or the Peekaboo beauty bags, things like that. Just something thinner, but really pretty. And then I always say that I'm gonna rewrap them, and I never do. This is the Copper Penny Textured Metallic. This is not my favorite backing. This is like a fuzzy flannel backing. But sometimes things are just too pretty. So I love making tote bags out of fabrics like this, but I wouldn't make a substantial handbag just because I don't really love the way that feels. But for fun totes or accessories, I love their vinyls. Oh, it's so pretty. Yeah, I love that. I don't think I've ever bought a vinyl from My Punk Broidery and been like, nope, don't like that. I'm always very happy with my order. So this is the Fawn Metallic. I also love that they label them, so you could like cut this off and save it on a little ring so that you know later and have like a reference for what it looks like. Oh, super pretty. So again, this is that like fuzzy flannel backing that I don't love, but again, for totes and stuff, it's totally fine. And this is the color Fawn Metallic. I'm very fond of it. Ugh, bad joke. Okay, so this next one, I don't believe has a label, but this is a really pretty color. I think this is not a Geo Glitter. I can't remember what this is, but it's so pretty. This is kind of like their whipped, I think it's whipped vinyls or something like that. I got some lime glitter, glitter vinyl. And this is a feeling that I do like. It's got the woven backing and it's just like a marine vinyl and it's pretty thick, but it can be quite sticky. So if you don't have a walking foot, it is not domestic machine friendly. I know some people use like receipt paper or parchment paper. They say that works for them, but I never had the patience for it. This is the white Geo Glitter. I'm not gonna take this apart because I have some, but I wanted another backup. This one is just the prettiest. I love their Geo Glitters. Again, they're that fuzzy backing. Great for accessories though. Ooh, Sailor Blue Sparkle Canvas. Oh, super pretty. So hopefully you guys can see. This is much thinner than the glitter vinyl and it's got a woven backing to it. So great for accents, great for domestic machines. Love the glitter. I also got some lime, just marine vinyl. This is really nice. It's a good quality feeling, but it's pretty cheap per roll. Magenta marine vinyl. Love that. And these are great for little accessories or if you're new to vinyl, just kind of dipping your toe into. Passion pink glitter vinyl. They have really good reference photos of their website of all the different pinks. This one's really pretty and it's the passion pink glitter. This is Roundup. Oh, that's fun. It's really pretty. It's almost got like a tapestry texture. The backing isn't too fuzzy, so I would recommend this for a bag. And you could use this as like the main panel or even accents. It's just got such a cool texture to it. I really like that. Oh, okay. This is the English Tea Rose Holographic. Oh my gosh, they had pictures online and everyone's been tagging me. Well, mostly Mopsy, but I was like, I'm finally gonna get some. So pretty. I thought this would be fun on a Devon. It's a little bit thin. It reminds me of the glitter canvas, but I'm not mad at it because it was under the canvas section, I believe, or like the printed vinyls. Ah. The texture on it is just so cool and I love the way it looks. It's very like Mad Hattery with all the colors and like psychedelic. Okay, and then my last one in here is Dots, Dots, Dots. Oh, that's pretty too. So this is kind of like the Roundup one. Really cool. Reminds me of like a medical office and I don't know why. But that's really cool. And it does have a bit of a texture to it, but it's got a nice marine vinyl woven backing. So you can tell that it's like upholstery quality. No, not sure if you can see the lines in the back, but it's kind of like if you go to Joann's and you see the ones on the roll and they have those different lines in them. Okay, I'm going to now open this Swoon box. So if you don't want to know what's inside, stop watching. Okay, so I'm gonna open the Swoon box and we'll see what's inside. This is the bi-monthly sewing subscription box. And I just think it's so fun to see what comes inside. So let's see what's inside. Oh, that's so cool. Whoa, whoa, okay. So they sent the paper Lola pattern, which is really cool that you actually get that in your package. And let's see what's in here. I love that she has these little bags. It says that there are gunmetal strap anchors. Wow. Oh, cool. Nice. So these are similar to the ones I sell, but they They definitely feel a little different, especially the back, but they feel really, really nice and high quality. So gunmetal strap anchors. Oh my God, I'm so excited about this fabric. Okay, and then she included a Kai rotary cutter. That is insane. So the Lola paper pattern is valued at $10. The gunmetal strap anchors are valued at $9. There is an ultimate marking pencil, which is valued at $6. This looks really cool. I'm excited to actually use this. And then color changing panels. Panels. Wow. This is so cool. Like, what? This is probably, is this the new version or the old version? That's a good question. I'm blown away at this. This is so cool. They're like pre-cut panels. And I don't know if you guys have seen, like Instagram ads or Facebook ads for this fabric, but when there's a light on it, the colors are insane. Okay, stand over there and shine your flashlight. Be my lighting man. Is it on? No. Okay. There we go. There you go. Yeah.
It's not.
It is in the camera. Oh, okay. Yeah, so that is the color changing panel. That is so freaking cool. No, don't move it. I move. You don't see the colors?
Not from here, no.
Oh. Okay, I just want to do this for hours, though.
That's nice.
Oh, it's gone. Are you leaving me?
Yes.
Okay, bye. Don't want it to seem scripted or anything. So that's in the box. That was amazing. And I love everything I got in the mail. So much. I don't even know that I want to make a Lola out of it, though. I want to make something. I want to sew with it, and I want to play with it so bad. I am curious, though, if this is a new Lola or the old Lola. No, it says 2019, so it's probably the new one, which is awesome because I have not printed that out. That's kind of genius. She's such a genius. Oh, wow. That is so cool how it's like a full pattern that you cut out. Why am I so mind blown at that? I don't even know. What is that? Oh. Yeah, the bottom panel comes together differently. Cool. Very cool. So, if you guys are not already subscribed to the Swoon subscription box, you're missing out. I don't know if she's got them open or not, but it's pretty cool. Oh my gosh, it's even got like the instructions. This is so cute. Okay, so that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. Let me know what kind of videos you guys like so that I'm releasing stuff you actually want to watch. And I hope that you have a good weekend or a good day or, you know, a good whatever when you're watching this, whenever you're watching this. Bye. Ben, these are just so cool. What do you think? He doesn't care. It's fine.